JP Morgan is being accused of silver manipulation. China's commerce chief says that our dollar printing is hurting its economy. And it looks like local and state governments are entering a meltdown. Oh yeah, and my favorite scary movies. Hey guys, it's October 28th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcat. First, China's commerce minister is saying that our dollar printing is hurting China. He's basically saying that we're getting out of control. Really? Really? He also says that exports are prepared to exchange rates. They're prepared for exchange rate changes. So he also said that export growth next year will be stable, but imports will soar. That's not really news there. Whatever happened to the anti-war movement? At one point, a million people were marching in the streets in a run-up to the invasion of Iraq. And then nothing. What happened to the anti-war movement? Well, it's really simple. There was no real anti-war movement. Most of the people marching were marching against George W. Bush. Most of the people who were anti-war in the 2000s were anti-Bush, not really anti-war. Most of the people who were talking about bringing the troops home didn't really care about the troops. They were just using the troops as a political tool against George W. Bush. It was just a left-wing movement against George W. Bush. Because as soon as Democrats started to win elections and continue the wars, people just shut the hell up. People were just like... You know, it got really, really quiet because the Democrats were, in 2006, were talking about, you know, going in and we're going to bring the troops home with withdrawal and all this stuff. And as soon as they got in, they put on a big show. And by the end of the summer, they gave Bush every penny he wanted. And then when they won more elections in 2008 and Obama came in there, he continued the war in Iraq. He just rebranded it. And he escalated the war in Afghanistan, so there is no anti-war movement. And if anything, the people on the right should have been more involved in an anti-war effort. People like myself should have been more vocal. I wish I was more vocal, but I don't know if it would have made much of a difference. Anyway, the meltdown. Local and state governments are entering into a meltdown. The situation is so severe in Indiana that they're actually suggesting that they send disabled people, severely disabled people, to homeless shelters if they can't be taken care of at home. It's getting so bad. In Cincinnati, 169 firefighters could be facing layoffs. I mean, how many firefighters do they have? They're looking at $11 million in proposed cuts. We're seeing cuts everywhere. JP Morgan, HSBC, have both been accused of manipulating silver. Basically, they're saying that they amass enormous amounts of short positions, and they've been using this to actually manipulate silver futures. These are actually two different lawsuits. These are two separate lawsuits filed in federal court in Manhattan. Silver being manipulated. This is something that people have been talking about for the longest. And now we have somebody who's formally being accused of doing that. This is why I can't say silver is really an investment. Because if I say, you know, silver is a great investment, and, you know, first of all, it's like I'm giving out investment advice, and I'm not in a position to be giving out investment advice. Another thing is, you start saying silver is an investment, people start expecting to buy at one price and then sell it at an even higher price. And that's not really how it always works. For me, I'm not so much worried if silver is down. You know, I'm not looking at it and saying, oh man, I'm losing money. You know, that's not how I look at it. I look at it as a way of really just storing just value. Meg Whitman spent $163 million on her gubernatorial campaign. She's running for governor in California. She spent $163 million. Who would spend that kind of money for a government job? That makes absolutely no sense to me. I think that's crazy. Okay, that's absolutely insane. I don't know if I would even vote for somebody who's that dedicated to just be governor, you know. I don't know. Okay, Halloween's coming up, so I want to know what's your favorite scary movies. My favorite ones include The Ring. Very chilling story. It was based on a Japanese movie. I also like Nightmare on Elm Street 3, Dream Masters. This is the one where Freddy kills a bunch of teenagers in a psych ward. I also like Silence of the Lambs. Favorite serial killer movie. Well, one of my favorite. Actually, my favorite serial killer movie is Seven. The ending is just perfect. Just absolutely perfect. Vampire movies. I usually don't like animation, but I like Blood, The Last Vampire. It's kind of skimpy on the story, but the animation is amazing. Vampire D is better at story. It's also animation. But live action films, Interview with the Vampire. That's my all-time favorite one. It showed vampires as being like real people, but it didn't neglect the fact that they're still killers. I love the Blade franchise. I love Underworld. I always enjoy the action in my vampire movies. And, well, my favorite vampire movies. Zombies. I like Zombieland. It's so funny. I should pay more attention to the cardio rule, actually. And Planet Terror, I love that grindhouse raw B-movie look. It's awesome. Anyway, so what are some of your favorite zombie vampire movies? What are some of your favorite scary movies? What's the scariest movie you've ever seen? All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. So get your food and water and get a gun to protect it from zombies. Bye.